Different takes on what it will take to fix Illinois' budget mess. Elizabeth?
Well, Eddie, it is a mess. Illinois is currently facing at least a $3 billion budget shortfall this year, with another $3 billion in unpaid bills. And it only gets worse for next year's 2011 budget, with a projected shortfall of some $12 billion out of the $32 billion budget. 2,000 union members, human service providers, and other advocacy groups forming a coalition called the Responsible Budget Coalition rallied in Springfield today. The group called for new revenues from both an increased state income tax and sales tax. But others say raising taxes is exactly the wrong way to go, that new cuts must be made. And now joining us to try and shed a little insight into the budget mess are John Tillman, CEO of the Illinois Policy Institute, a research organization dedicated to supporting free market principles. Sheila Weinberg, founder and CEO of the Institute for Truth in Accounting. They try to encourage governments to produce financial reports that are comprehensive and transparent. And Josh Kalven, editor at Progress Illinois, a progressive news website sponsored by the Illinois State Council of Service Employees International Union. Welcome all of you to Chicago Tonight.
Thank you.
Well, with all these huge budget problems that I just went over, the legislators are in Springfield for their two-week veto session. So, Josh Kalven, why does it look like they're not going to address them?
Well, there's this issue of the vote threshold. When you're in a regular session, it just takes a simple majority to pass bills outside of the regular session, whether it's a special session or a veto session like we're in right now.
There's a higher threshold.
So even though it's such a mess, it looks like they couldn't get the votes together to do anything about it?
Exactly. So right now it's waiting for
January when it resets. We're back to a simple majority, and it's going to be all go at that point.
So Sheila Weinberg, can this state wait until January to tackle these huge problems? And what are we talking about in terms of numbers? I mentioned some. But there are numbers floating around all over the place. What are your numbers?
That's a huge problem with the budget process, is there are numbers floating around. We, as you said, we want transparency and accountability in the budget. What they want is to continue the gimmicks. You know, they've been balancing the budget for decades now, and we find ourselves between 82 and some people say $100 billion in debt. I do not know how you go into debt and balance your budget at the same time, but they continue to do that. And I suspect they'll continue to play those games this year also.
But even this year, they're not even saying that it's balanced. I mean, right now, today, for instance, or yesterday, actually, it was announced that their income tax revenues are going to fall by $850 million this year. And they're going to lose another $50 million in a shortfall from riverboat gaming receipts. So nobody's pretending this one is balanced. They're in such dire trouble. So let's talk about what can be done about it. Now, we have different opinions about what can be done about it here. John Tillman?
Well, the focus always is on revenues by many, and every state that's ever tried to solve a problem like this by increasing tax rates, it fails every time. It's failed in New York, fails in New Jersey, fails in California. We have many states to look at that have tried the solution. It just doesn't work. They have to focus on the spending side. The revenues for this state were at record rates prior to the economic slowdown, which is why we've had such a cliff that we've gone off of, because we overspent previously. Now is the time to reform spending. There's Medicaid reforms that can be done that can be saved somewhere between $500 million or more. Governor Quinn should call to reopen the public employee union contract. Public employees make on average 12% more than private sector employees. They have very generous benefit packages. Those things should all be on the table. He's a populist. He should be calling for those things to come out and be discussed so the people of the state can see where the real problems are. There's a number of things that can be done.
Let's stop there. Let's get some response to that. Josh Kalven, can we cut our way out of this mess?
Absolutely not. I mean, the boards like the Taxpayer Action Board and others
have looked at the type of Medicaid reforms that John is talking about and found much, much smaller savings. There's simply, you know, there are ideas out there, there are estimates being thrown out there, but we haven't seen any bills from the Republican side, any comprehensive budgets that get the job done.
Using
just cuts. And just what you're seeing right now with the quicksand, the revenue shortages, which were somewhat predicted earlier this year. I mean, when this stopgap budget was passed back in July, there was a lingering assumption that in January we might have to look at this year's budget again because no new revenue was created. There was simply $300 million borrowed and another $300 put off in terms of unpaid bills. So we didn't get the job done in July in terms of creating adequate revenue. Hopefully in January, with the Responsible Budget Coalition and with lawmakers, they can find a real solution.
Well, the Rockford Register-Star had a great analysis of this. They said they want to, legislators want to apply a Band-Aid when the patient needs open heart surgery. Any hope for open heart surgery, Sheila Weinberg?
I don't see any. I what they are doing down there is, you know, simple, you know, easy fixes. You know, there's only two ways to solve this. You either bring more revenue in, or you take less money out. And they seem to want to do the bandage, and in addition, they want to play with the numbers. In last year's budget, they, you know, borrowed $3 billion and claimed that as revenues. You know, how do you balance your budget in that atmosphere?
And you were saying that governments don't do the same kind of accounting as a business is required to do.
No, they do their books on a cash basis, which worked fine when they were only offering services, current services. But now that we have long-term, we're making long-term decisions, we need a model that accounts for those long-term decisions. What are the consequences of continually adding the pensions, continually this borrowing? And they don't look at that at all with this cash basis budget. That's why we're proposing that they switch to what we call fact-based budgeting, which is full accrual calculations and techniques, and use this system similar to what corporations are required to use.
But even if they did it, it wouldn't solve the budget problem. Even if we knew more about it, it wouldn't solve the budget problem.
No, but I think Sheila's exactly right, and they're doing great work with her organization to promote that. But really the question is, why are we in this hole that we're in? The reason we're in this hole is because when the budget cycle started, aggressive measures weren't taken. We actually proposed a budget solutions 2010 that did balance the budget without a tax hike. We proposed all kinds of ways to cut taxes that if they'd been started at that time, or cut spending rather, that if they'd been started at that time would have been accruing in the spending that's going on now. There are many steps that have been proposed that Governor Quinn and the legislature led by Mike Madigan and John Cullerton have not taken. They should be taking steps right now to do an up and down forensic audit of the entire state's regulatory environment, its tort environment, its wage laws to figure out how to get more jobs. Governor Quinn pointed out that the reason we have that shortfall in income taxes is because people are unemployed. He should be focusing on what can be done to increase employment by liberalizing the regulatory environment in the state and have employers have more opportunities to hire people.
That all may be good, Josh Kalven, but you're saying it's just not enough.
Well, I'm saying that we can't just hit the reset button.
The things that have contributed to this problem go back decades. I mean, the using of the pension system as essentially a credit card, underfunding it year after year after year, and no longer, you know, it's not compounding the interest at this point that it should be, so we're just way behind the ball on that one. And we need a large infusion of revenue to basically right the ship. And
now, do you disagree with that?
I definitely disagree. We don't need a large infusion of revenue. Let me just try to illustrate the point in simple terms. Population today is roughly the same as it was in 2005. And the revenues we're going to have this year are roughly the same as we had in 2005 for then Lieutenant Governor Quinn. There was no crisis then. What we should be doing is figuring out how we spent that.
But now there's huge deficits now, though.
But that's because the spending demands have outstripped that spending level in 2005. That's the point I'm trying to make, is that the revenues we have projected to come in this year are roughly the same as what came in roughly 2005, 2006, and our population is roughly the same. What we should all be doing, and what the governor should be doing, and the entire staff should be doing, is going line by line and comparing those two budget years and figuring out why we're spending so much more money now. We're spending money on many more things. In 1998, there was 1.7 million people on Medicaid. In 2008, there was 2.7 million people on Medicaid, and our population only changed by a few percentage points. These are the reasons. One other quick point, there's a Walmart that wants to open up here in Chicago in the Chatham neighborhood that would give 500 jobs. We have over 10% unemployment. 500 jobs. They won't do it because the politicians in Chicago are more loyal to the unions of the employees of Jewel and Dominick's than they are to the people who need jobs in Chatham.